John Bunyan, a great pastor of the 17th century, was imprisoned for refusing to back down for preaching the gospel. He could have been released from his sentence earlier had he said he wouldn't preach anymore, but he wouldn't say such a thing. And it was while he was in prison that he wrote the classic Pilgrim's Progress, one of the great literary works of our time, translated into over 200 languages and has never been out of print. And it's reported that only the Bible has sold more copies. Later in his life, Bunyan wrote an autobiography called Grace Abounding to the Chief of Sinners. And in that autobiography, he wrote about his sufferings and he said, "If I would suffer rightly, I must first pass a sentence of death upon everything that can be properly called a thing of this life, even to reckon myself, my wife, my children, my health, my enjoyment, and all as dead to me and myself as dead to them. The second was to live upon God that is invisible. As Paul said in another place, the way not to faint is to look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things that are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal." We see the unseen God in Ruth chapter 2, verse 3. That text says, "So she set out and went and gleaned in the field of the reapers, and she happened to come to the part of the field belonging to Boaz." Think about that phrase, "she happened to come to the part of the field belonging to Boaz." It's an interesting one. We might say it this way, "as luck would have it." But why would the author phrase it in this way? Israelites didn't believe in luck or fate or things just happening. They believed that God was the one who caused the dice to land the way they did. They believed that God ordered the steps of man. So what the author is doing is he's toying with us. The original reader would have said, "as luck would have it, of course not. This is God. God's in the mix here. God is up to something." And it was God working in his providence that brought Naomi and Ruth back to Bethlehem at the time of the barley season. Can you imagine if they had gotten there a month earlier or a month later? We wouldn't have this story, but God's timing and providence is always perfect. So listen to me. Our God, and only our God, is the God of providence. Only the God of the Bible is continually involved with all created things in such a way in order to direct them to fulfill His purposes. And God allows and ordains tragic heartache to set the stage for His true hero. Bleak situations set the stage for God's intervention. Today when you pray, please pray for Stephen Schroeder and his family, our missionaries in Papua New Guinea. And also remember the Songhay Life Word broadcast that's heard throughout Burkina Faso, Guinea, Mali, and Mauritania.